But Quran actually, everywhere you can see, it is consistent. That's why Quran keeps saying that, you know, if Quran had been from someone other than Allah, they would have found so many incoherences and differences in the Quran. But Quran is so consistent all the time. It has been revealed in the 23 years, but you never find anywhere in the Quran inconsistency. Using the words of the Arabic language so consistently. And I, you know, the examples, there are so many examples in the Quran, you know, very, very clear. I am going to give you a few examples to make it clear. You know, one word in Arabic language comes abd. Abd means slave. You know, abada ya'budu means to worship. Iyaka na'budu, you we worship. Ibada means worshiping Allah, or slavery. So abd means slave. Abd has got two plural in Arabic language, two jama, two plural in Arabic language. One is ibad and one is abid, which I have written here. Abid and ibad. So both are plural of abd. Abd means slaves. And ibad means slaves, and abid also means slaves. Do you see the difference between two words, ibad and abid? You see the difference. Ibad, you know, has got in Arabic language basically after ba, there's alif, ibad, long, and abid is like, you know, ya. It go. These are two different. Both are actually plural of abd, but the Quran actually is very consistent to use both of them in the right place. You never find, and nobody can translate these two words as they are in the Quran. Nobody can translate. People always translate them as slaves. And slaves actually have two meanings. When you use the word slave, they have two meanings. One meaning is their relation, master's relation to the slave. That is full ownership. You have full power, do whatever you like. That is abd. Another meaning of abd is the slave's relationship to the master. Obedience, action, doing, following the command, two different things. So when master wants to show that how he has control over his slave and how the slave is under his command and in a full ownership, so when the Arabic language, the plural actually comes abid. And if you want to show that your slave actually obedient to you and he has full command to listen to you or not to listen to you, action from the slave, then the plural is what? Ibad. Arabs very often, many of them, they don't know these differences, and they don't use like that. But the Quran is very consistent. When Quran uses abid, it always in those places where Quran wants to show that how much Allah has got control and power over the people. They can't do anything, they can't disobey him, they cannot differ from him, they're under full control of him. Then Quran uses word abid. When Quran uses the word slaves, to show that the people have to listen to Allah, to obey him, then the Quran used the word ibad. Abid and ibad, they are two different plurals of the same word abd.